Get ready to match the stars from Chips, Robert Pine, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, WKRP in Cincinnati, Lonnie Anderson, from The Price is Right, Bob Barker, and Patty North, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, is the star of Match Game 78, Gene Reagan.
Thank you very much. Listen, now, if you haven't seen this lady's show, WKRC, what's the name of it?
WKRP.
WKRP Cincinnati. It really is a funny, funny show. You know, at first I said, what kind of a dumb title is that for you? But the cast is marvelous. She is terrific in it. It's too bad she's so ugly. But... No, you're very darling.
I know, it's a shame about her body, isn't it?
Yeah, it's too bad about her body, but we're going to send her to camp and build her up a little bit.
Right.
Everything's going to be all right. Myrna Mae Meth here and Sherry Chang are the two players. Now, Myrna Mae is the current champ. She has $600 to her credit, and we are meeting for the first time Sherry Chang. I'll drink to you, Sherry. Who are you?
Who am I?
Who is Sherry Chang?
Oh, young girl that's from Denver.
Denver?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Been there about 5 years.
Right.
I fly for an airline.
Uh-huh.
And I like a lot of sports. I've done quite a few things like skiing, golf, tennis,
yep.
jogging, that type
yep.
of thing.
Where are you from originally, Sherry?
Southern California.
Southern Cal. Yeah. Well, you're a very pretty girl.
Thank you.
And we wish you the best, and we'll start this game right after we do a little business with America. Okay? Watch it. Here we go. Round one. Sherry, you have a choice of A or B.
I'll take B, please.
B it is.
Jack said,
this T-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with an entire orchestra on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw. I wish I were playing. I've got a wonderful answer for this.
Give it to me, hon. I'll show you.
A wonderful answer. I can't give you answers. That's not allowed.
That's against the law.
After you show us your answer.
The only answer.
No.
Well, that I know.
You have an entire orchestra
right.
on our front.
Some funny things occur to me.
Okay.
But should I?
Wonderful. That was my answer.
Should.
Yes.
That's what the first thing that occurred to me.
Yes.
But now she will never say that.
Oh, I see. Well, you have to do whatever you think she will say.
That's what I've done.
Okay. All right. That's the way to play the game. Here we go.
I want that girl to win.
All right. He wants that girl to win. Sherry, are you ready?
I think so.
Jack said, this T-shirt craze is really wild. I just saw a girl with an entire orchestra on her front. She had the biggest blanks I ever saw.
Cymbals.
Cymbals. And I think that's a very imaginative answer, one that did not cross my mind, and it tickles my fancy. Biggest cymbals. You see, there's kind
yeah,
of a,
that's a very
double play there.
Imaginative answer,
yes.
Sherry. And that's, well, after you pound cymbals a while, they could turn into tubas. Yes!
Tubas. She had the biggest tubas I ever saw. Well, that's good, too. Now, cymbals and tubas are all good here.
They're all good. Yeah. Oh, he just hit my foot. You
Sorry.
See, there is no wastebasket. Where we put that down there, it all goes on the floor. But if it hits your foot exactly right, you get a very bad paper cut.
Kiss her foot, Robert.
No, I said she had the biggest instruments on the island.
Okay. All right.
The biggest instruments on the island.
Yes, sir. Do you care to do business with this office?
Miss Music. You should do albums, sweetheart. Kettle drums.
Kettle drums. Oh, now that's interesting, because if you turn them upside down, they look exactly like... Yeah.
You want my answer? Bassoons.
Bassoons is a wonderful answer.
Now that is a marvelous answer.
Yeah.
That's what I wanted to put down.
You wanted to put down
but
bassoon.
But I thought she would just say boobs.
That's why I said boo.
Right.
Even in spite of the orchestra.
Yeah.
And this audience is worse than the one yesterday. And the one yesterday was the pits.
Yes.
Speaking of orchestras.
Sherry, you want the answer cymbals, eh? No.
Not one of you will ever get in Prices Right.
Just don't let them find your car in the parking lot.
I rode my leftover moped from the show.
Okay. We want a pair of cymbals here is what we want here, Patty Deutsch. And Sherry, Patty's the kind of girl who would give you cymbals, because it's a weird answer.
Would you settle for maracas?
Maracas!
I think that's good.
Wonderful. No, you wouldn't hear what they were saying around the office was bongo drums. The bongo drums, well, you didn't like that one either. Okay. Now, Myrna May, here we go with you. At the airport, Sally said, I can tell this is going to be a no-frills flight. The airplane doesn't have any blanks.
Do it again, hon.
Got the idea, Myrna May? Okay, we are ready for your answer.
Seats.
No seats. No-frills flight would have no seats, according to Myrna May. Yes, sir, Robert Pine.
I played it as straight and as down the middle as I could, and I came up with seats.
Seats it is? Yes?
I played it as straight and down the middle as I possibly could, and I also came up with seats.
That's two.
I played it straight and as down the middle as I could, and for some wonderful reason, I too came up with seats.
Yes, right. Well, friends, what this means is that everybody copied from Robert Pine.
That's absolutely right.
Now, let's see if everybody copied from Lonnie Anderson. Lonnie, no frills flight. I can see it, but it doesn't have any blanks.
Oh, I hate to break this up. I said wings.
Wings.
I did not see her answer, I swear, and I, too, said wings.
Uh-huh.
You didn't see her answer either, did you, Patty?
No? I didn't see her answer, and I didn't see his answer.
And what'd you say?
Doors.
No doors, eh? Okay, 3-0 to score at the end of round one. Round two coming up later. Now I'm ready. Okay, we go to round two. This is the final round, ladies. Sherry, you want A or B?
Try B again.
B again? Here it is. Mm-hmm. Did you hear that Ugly Edna is the centerfold for Plumbers Monthly? They picked her because her face looks like a blank.
Gene?
Yes?
The last week that I was on with you...
Yes.
We got some laughs, and a couple of people at my shows during commercials I'm talking, they suggested that you and I should have a show of our own. And I was thinking that would be a marvelous idea, because I know that you sing.
Yes.
You could sing, and you could dance.
Yes.
And you tell jokes.
And what would you do?
I'd do everything else.
Oh, yeah. Okay, Sherry Chang. All right, we'll be ready in a second here. Did you hear that Ugly Edna is the centerfold for Plumbers Monthly? They picked her because her face looks like a blank.
A sewer.
A sewer. I don't know where that's going to get you.
Probably nowhere.
I do.
You,
Santa Monica.
No. Right. I think it's going to get her back to Denver, California is where it's going to get her. Anyway, good luck to you, Sherry. We'll find out what happens now with Robert Pine, the leadoff man.
Yes, yes. It's a pipe is a sewer.
A pipe is part of a sewer, but not
minute.
Exactly. No.
No imagination.
That's right.
Nothing.
Show.
I said you look like a monkey wrench.
Monkey wrench?
Yeah.
Wait
good
a
one.
Minute. You know he's always doing the pathetic award.
Yeah.
This, he gets the bad taste award.
Bad taste award?
Right. Okay. You're going to love it.
Moi? Her face looks like a toilet.
I love your restraint. Hello, Lonnie.
Hello, I hate to follow that. A faucet.
A faucet. Well, if it were a fair. Now, you got a match. As a matter of fact,
through.
It's all over. It's all over right now. Myrna May Matthews won another game. What do you have, Bob and Patty?
Plumber's friend.
Plumber's friend. And a plumber's friend. Right there, a little blue spot, if you would, please. Well, Sherry, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Going to send a whole mountain of gifts your way. Sherry Chang, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. Now, here it is again, Myrna May. And let's get right to it. We polled another studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. Board of Blaine. Remember, $500 for matching the most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Three of these six brilliant, beautiful people will help you.
Brett.
Board of Directors.
Charles.
A board that Brett missed. Board of Education.
Now, Lonnie, third is tough.
I know.
Third
it's
is very
terrible.
Difficult, but something will come
something
to you from
will.
Some direction.
This has happened to me in my
yes.
past. Things have come to me. Board of.
Now
yes, wait.
Made this from your
board of Plywood.
Oh, just. They're all. Okay. I'm being rained upon by answers.
Yes.
How about Board of Health?
Yeah. Board of Health? Oh, that's a good one. So you have Board of Health, Board of Directors, and Board of Education. Those are the three. Choose one or give us one of your own.
I'm going to go with directors.
Board of directors. That was Brett's answer. We'll find out if it's up there. You apparently do not agree with her choice? No. All right, wait a minute. If you disagree, raise your hand. Well, most of them disagree. If you agree, raise your hand. Oh, it's 50-50, isn't it? All right, let's take a look at the $100 response.
Somewhere.
Board of Health. Okay, that was Lonnie's answer. Board of Directors, what we want. May we see the next one, please? Board of Education.
Ha, ha, ha.
All right, Charles' answer.
What if it's not
I think
there
you're
all?
Right.
Think so?
I think they're going to be wrong.
I hope so.
Now remember, if you're wrong, you have to boo yourself. Just turn to the person next to you and say, boo. Okay, you have to do that now.
But what if it's not there?
No, I mean, if she's right, you're wrong. That's the only fair thing. You got to give yourself a boo. You boo them, you got to boo yourself. All right, slide it, Ori. You're wrong. Okay, now Sherry, another $500. Playing for 10 times that amount means $5,000. The least you can play for, howsomever, you step back here into my office and give the wheel a spin as you did before and see if you can double her up. There she goes. Double it up. Double. Let's get a double. Get a double. You did do a double. You're playing for $10,000 with Patty Deutsch.
Again.
Okay. All right, swing around here, and good luck to you, Myrna Maymouth. Here it is. Blank, dark, D-A-R-K. Blank, dark. Okay, Myrna May, give us the answer that Patty's written on the card. If you do that, you get $10,000. What do you say?
Pitch.
Pitch dark, she says. $10,000. Okay, Patty, she says pitch dark will match you for $10,000. What do you say to that?
I said after dark.
After dark.
It's pitch black, not pitch dark.
It's pitch black?
Yes,
yeah.
It's pitch black.
Pitch black, okay. All right, well, you're close, and you've picked up a little more money. You got a total of $1,200 now. You'll meet another player later. Right now, we want to do a little business with America. Thank you, Johnny O. Here we go, and let's welcome Robin Marker. Applause, applause, applause. Applause, applause, applause. Now, Robin, we'd like to find out a little bit about you.
Okay, I live in San Diego, and I'm going to school there, studying to be an evidence technician.
And what technician? I didn't hear you.
Evidence technician, you know, fingerprints and stuff like that.
Oh, I
in the
see.
Lab.
Yeah.
And I scoop ice cream on the side.
You like ice cream?
Love it.
Yes. Well, you haven't been eating too much because you haven't gained any
weight. I don't know where it hides, but I eat an awful lot of it.
You do? Well, you must work very hard and work off all that ice cream with your calorie expenditure. Now, good luck to you, Robin.
Thank you.
And Myrna May, let's begin by asking you to make a selection.
A, please.
A it is. All right. There's a shortage of everything these days. I mean, there's a shortage of everything. Even the tooth fairy has a shortage of teeth. And that's why she's holding blank for ransom. Even the tooth fairy has a shortage of teeth. That's why she's holding blank for ransom. Robin, you ready?
Oh, I don't know. Okay.
There is a shortage of everything these days. Even the tooth fairy has a shortage of teeth, and that's why she's holding blank for ransom.
Moby Dick?
He has a lot of teeth.
No. Moby Dick is famous for his teeth.
Well, he has a lot of them, doesn't he?
Has a lot of them. Well, there's one living thing that has more teeth than Moby Dick. Show her, Robert Pine.
Yes, it's a whale of a President Carter.
President Carter!
That's what I said.
He has many more teeth than Moby Dick by a long shot, doesn't he?
By a long tooth.
32. Yes. They just look like they're 64.
Yeah.
But he, anyway, you know.
Yes.
What's his name? He's always talking about his jackets and his cap and the $30,000 he spent on his teeth and everything. Yes. So I put Charles Nelson Reilly.
Okay. Well, we won't say anything to him about that.
Don't tell him.
I won't reveal your secret.
Sad. I said President Carter.
There's the other guy. Right. Okay. Now, Lonnie.
We know where it's at.
Even though the tooth fairy's a shortage of teeth, that's why she's holding blank for ransom.
Yes, and I copied Bob's answer, and yes. I said President Carter.
Listen,
well,
it was a terrific.
Teeth,
yeah.
Now, there's a nice mouthful.
Thank you.
Again. As I said, you complimented me on my President Carter answer, and again, I did not make a match.
I would say that would be the definitive answer now that you look at it.
I do agree. We have one to go yet.
I think that a compliment from you is the worst thing that can happen to an answer.
Okay, now, I do not expect Patty to say President Carter. I simply do not expect that.
Mary Tyler Moore.
Okay.
Perfect.
Now, you see,
She's got a lot of important teeth.
She does not have a... She has one tooth that goes from here to here.
I didn't know that.
Yes, that's the way it is.
She has the best teeth in the business.
Yes, she has.
Great
wonderful teeth. Myrna May, you're in the catbird seat, as they say. All you need to do is match one to win another game. Fred said my dog... It's round one. What's wrong with me? You got
Catch up, hon.
Catch up time. Fred said my dog thinks he's human.
Uh-oh.
He's the only dog in the world who can't go to sleep without a blank. He thinks he's human. Only dog in the world who can't go to sleep without a blank. He thinks he's human.
He thinks he's human.
Thinks he's human. That's a cue.
Without A.
Without A.
He can't go to sleep without a blank. Okay? Okay.
It seems to me that these are more difficult this week than they usually are.
Really?
Yeah. Do you have new writers?
No, we got the same bunch of young weirdos.
Well, then I think you need new writers.
Well, let's get some new ones.
Okay, Myrna May. Fred said my dog thinks he's human. He's the only dog in the world who can't go to sleep without a blank.
Blanket.
A what?
Blanket.
A blanket, she said. Okay. She said a blanket, Robert.
Having a six-year-old daughter, every time she goes to sleep, she wants a glass of water.
A glass of water. That's one of the things.
You know.
Right. They always ask, oh, Daddy, I want a glass of water. What do you say?
I said, I want a bottle of gin. No, I said a cup of hot cocoa and some cookies.
Oh, sweet answer, yes.
No.
A glass of warm milk or Ovaltine.
That'll do it. Roger, would you throw the box of Kleenex up? She spilled a little coffee.
Oh,
and I
want
to sop it up there before it gets too soaked in there. Thank you. Fred said my dog thinks he's human, the only dog in the world who can't go to sleep without a...
His teddy bear.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a sweet answer.
A wonderful answer. Sweet answer.
Not having children yeah. hating milk, and being a drunk myself, I said nightcap.
Nightcap. We're looking for a blanket. Security blanket. Any kind of blanket.
No, it's a reprise of a teddy.
A teddy bear. Okay, so there we are at the end of round one and no score, and now we've got a message for you. Listen, don't forget to watch Robert Pine and Chips and Lonnie Anderson
yes.
on WKRP Cincinnati. Here, I'm Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us next time for Match Game 78. Goodbye.
Speaking for Match Game 78, a marketing. This program was edited for broadcast.